Mama Bear is an autonomous robotic system on a quest for the perfect shape. After 30,000 experiments, did it build the perfect structure? Find out on NSF Science now. Today, autonomous robots are everywhere. They entertain our children, clean our floors, deliver medicine, move heavy equipment, and are in manufacturing assembly lines. But this robot is different. Meet Mama Bear, which stands for Mechanics of Additively Manufactured Architectures, Bayesian Experimental Autonomous Research, an autonomous robotic system on a quest to create the most efficient energy-absorbing shape ever, built to protect, leading to new life-saving applications.
When you're thinking about protecting something, it's important not to damage it and how the forces or the stresses or the accelerations define when it's going to be damaged. And so the most energy you can absorb before that damage occurs defines the mechanical energy absorbing efficiency. So the measure of how good a material or structure is at protecting a specific item.
This system was developed in 2018 by Keith Brown and his NSF-supported team at the CAB Lab at Boston University. CAB Lab has run over 30,000 experiments testing how much energy each shape can absorb and how its shape changed after being crushed with a pressure equal to an Arabian horse standing on a quarter.
An experiment that's performed by Mama Bear comprises first designing a three-dimensional structure, printing it, retrieving it with a robotic arm, weighing it to do some quality control and characterization, taking photographs of it, and then compressing it to failure. After that, it's retrieved and put in a bin for future discard or recycle.
As an experiment in robot autonomy, Mama Bear learns as it builds shape after shape.
It's important to note that Mama Bear is a closed-loop system that learns from each experiment. So after each experiment takes place, the data is analyzed, and then it builds a sophisticated model to try to understand how the design choices influence the mechanical properties. So each experiment's learning, and it's building a new understanding as it goes, trying to find better and better structures.
After 21,000 experiments running continuously for 3 years, filling dozens of boxes of 3D-printed structures, the robot finds the most efficient structure, besting the record of 71% efficiency at absorbing energy.
The record-breaking structure, we termed it Willow. It's basically a cylindrical shell that we've perturbed. And the thing about cylindrical shells is that mechanically speaking, they're very prone to being poor because they have a buckling phenomena and they're very susceptible to defects. So it's actually surprising that a cylindrical shell could be so efficient. And so what Mama Bear learned how to do was to use complicated twists and a tapering shape that allowed it to have really efficient plasticity that prevented buckling from being a big mechanical factor and also made it so defects wouldn't matter as much.
So why build so many shapes? The structure must strike the perfect balance. Not so strong to cause damage to whatever it's supposed to protect, but strong enough to absorb the impact.
So we were looking to explore combinations of materials and structure that absorb mechanical energy. This is important in things like protective equipment, safety equipment, crumple zones in cars, where you need to protect things.
There are countless uses for something that can efficiently absorb energy, like helmets, knee pads, wrist guards for athletes, and even cushioning delicate electronics and bumpers in cars. This is the future of self-driving labs, combining the best of both worlds.
So one thing that stood out to us about this research is it was 2 years or so of running what people call a self-driving lab, which makes you think that this is a system that operates by itself. But the thing that we realized in running this is that the people interacting with the system over a two-year span make a lot of choices and make a lot of decisions and interact with this system. And so this experience of running the system for 2 years gave us a real understanding of what it's like to interact with that.
While the extensive data from these experiments is publicly available, it has already resulted in a real-life application, helping design new helmet padding for U.S. Army soldiers.